Today we're going to learn how to find a remainder in your calculator. Alright, because currently, if you look through the video, you will see that you would do long division, regular division. So for example, if I had something like 8.95 and I wanted to do regular division, I would say what times 8 gets me closest to the first number, as long as it's equal to or higher. So that's 1 times 8, which gives me 8, and I need to subtract. Then, since that's 0, I bring down my next number. If this number is higher, I go what times that number gets me closest to 9. Of course, that's 1 times 8, which gives me 8, 1, and then I need to bring down my 5. 15, well, 2 times 8 is 16, so that's too large. So again, 1 times 8 gives me 8. When I subtract these two, I get 7. So my answer is 111, remainder 7. But who wants to do all of this work when we have our calculator that we have purchased? So let's turn our calculator on and see what we need to do. All right. So the first thing is you have to do regular division. So you have to divide these numbers, just basically 895, right? Divided by 8. And the first number is your whole number, just like we got over here, 111. And that's 111. So that's 111. That's your whole number. This is not your remainder. Please don't put R.875. That's not how it works. We see that our remainder is 7. So we're going to use the remainder function in our calculator. What you do is you go under alpha, you go to math, you go over to num, N-U-M, with this over key here. See at the top, you went from math over to num, and you're going to scroll down till you see remainder and hit enter. Now you're going to put in your two numbers, but to put in 895 divided by 8, you cannot use the division sign or it will give you an error. See, if you try to do 895 divided by 8, it's going to give you an error because you can't do that. What you need to do is you have to put in 895 comma 8, and the comma is on top of the 7. So anytime you're doing any of these things, you'll use a comma. 895 comma 8. Close your parentheses, and then you have remainder 7. R7, just like we had the first time. Let's do one more example. Alright, and this time I'm not going to do the long division. I'm just going to have 496 divided by 7, and I'm going to get my answer. Again, I'm going to take 496 and divide it by 7. And my first answer, my part of my answer is 70. That's the whole number. And then I'm going to go to math, num. I'm going to scroll down to remainder, or I can hit 0, hit enter. And again, I'm going to put in 496 comma, right? 7. Close my parentheses, and I'm going to get remainder 6. And this is the correct answer, 70 remainder 6. So that's how you avoid the long division and do your division in the calculator.